Hi everyone, this is Theo from PragueBlocks.com. Today I want to share with you some tips and tricks that I use when sketching on public transport, such as on the bus, on the train, at bus or train stations, or when waiting for the ferry or at the airport. I will show you some of my sketches and talk about the techniques as well. The most important thing when drawing in public, especially when you are drawing people, is try to avoid eye contact. Some members of the public, they are a bit uncomfortable when they know that they are being drawn. They may actually come over and ask you why are you drawing them, whether you have the right to do so. And if they do approach you, just say that you are attending an art class and your art teacher has told you to practice drawing in public. But really, try to avoid eye contact so that none of those things will happen. It is usually when they see that you're looking at them, you're drawing something on the paper, that they get suspicious. So to avoid all those things that I've said, just avoid eye contact. And there are some tricks that I personally use to avoid eye contact. Now, if it's possible, I guess the most foolproof way to avoid eye contact is get a pair of sunglasses. That is a foolproof way to prevent people from knowing that you're drawing them, that you're looking at them. But since I'm wearing glasses, I use some other techniques. Like, for example, I probably wouldn't look at them directly. I would look to the side of their eyes. Maybe I would look at the ear. Once you do not have the eye contact, once you are not looking into their eyes, they will be a bit confused. They don't know what you're doing. You're like staring into blank space to them. For example, let me demonstrate a technique right now. So right now I'm actually looking at the LCD screen that is beside my camera. Now, when I look at my LCD screen versus looking directly into your eyes, can you see the level of engagement there is? So once I look away, immediately it seems that I am actually staring into blank space. And sometimes when I catch people that I'm drawing, they are suspicious. They are looking at me like, what am I doing? Am I drawing them? I would look to the side of their face. I would look at their ear for a few seconds like this and pretend that I'm thinking about something, and then look back at them wondering why they are looking at me. So the tables are turned that way. When you are drawing, try not to move your head too much. For example, I have my sketchbook. I am on the train, either standing or sitting down, and I have spotted some people that I want to draw. So I would take out my sketchbook and basically just draw like this. I would look at them by glancing instead of tilting my head up and down. If I keep moving my head up and down, people are going to notice I'm doing something, and that movement is going to get their attention and they would look at you and try to figure out what you're doing. So for me, I would just try and keep my head still like this and just look at them by glancing my eyes at them once in a while and glance very quickly so that I can get back to my sketchbook, just very quickly so that they won't notice anything wrong. And if you do not move, people are not going to pay attention to you. Now, the other technique that I use sometimes is I would use my sketchbook basically just to block the person's line of vision. So if I want to draw something and I really have to look up because there are a lot of details there, I would use this sketchbook basically just to block the line of vision so that I can draw other parts of the body. For example, I might want to draw the side of the hair, the head. I want to draw this side, but once I block the eyes, I will be able to draw the side, the hairline here, the ears and things like that. And if I block the line of vision like this, I can draw the bottom half of the body. I can draw how they are playing with their smartphones, the bags that they are using, or their shoes, their clothes. So this is one trick that I use quite often as well. So those are just some tricks that I use mainly to avoid eye contact. And now let me show you some of the sketches that I have drawn on the train for the past few days. Here I have two sketchbooks. Let me show you the one that I used in 2014, which is this hardcover sketchbook. Hardcover sketchbooks like this is a bit difficult to hold, especially when you are standing and drawing. So for example, to draw this sketch, I was actually standing on the side and this person was sitting down. So in order to draw this, I had to fold my sketchbook something like this so that there are no moving parts. If I hold it like this, there would be no way for me to draw it. So I either hold it like this sometimes. If my hand is tired, I will switch position to draw like this and basically switch position again, because it's a bit tiring to hold the sketchbook, especially hardcover sketchbooks like this. So if you can actually try and get a spiral bound sketchbook, because this can fold all the way to the back and it's very easy to hold, much easier compared to the hardcover sketchbook. So let me show you some sketches that I have drawn 3 years ago. Most of the sketches in this sketchbook were drawn with pen and ink. I did not use a lot of watercolor, so I tried out different colored pens. If you feel intimidated when drawing outdoors, don't draw people first. You can try drawing objects like how they are playing with their handphones, draw their hands, or you can even draw shoes, draw feet. So I had with me 3 pens with 3 different colors. So while drawing, I switched to a different color. When drawing the clothes, I switched to green. When drawing the body, I switched to this brown color, and the hair, I use black ink. I try to keep the art very simple. I try to connect all the lines. I try to draw in one swift movement, basically just close up all the shapes so that the form is easy to recognize and to read. So this is also a very simple drawing. This is almost like those art, the style that you see in coloring books. I cannot remember if I use markers. This is probably watercolor. So this book is able to absorb some light washes. So this was drawn in 2014. Most of these people, they are actually just checking out their phone. So when I'm drawing them, they usually don't know that I am actually drawing them. And this is very good practice for drawing people, because every person on the train is going to look different. And as you're drawing, you're also honing your observation skills. So this is an unusual perspective, and this is what I really like about drawing on a train, because when you're drawing on a train, there is perspective going on, and if you draw people sitting down, they would be foreshortened, their legs would be a bit shorter because they are sitting down, or in this case, I'm standing up, this guy is sitting down on my left side. So the perspective, the angle that I'm looking at him is very different compared to these people where I'm looking at them straight on. So this is very good practice to practice your observation skills as well as your alignment skills. Sometimes it's not possible for me to complete the whole drawing. For example, I was trying to draw this baby that is inside a pram, but I think they probably left halfway. They reached their station, so they step out of the train, and I had to leave the sketch like this, uncompleted. So some of my sketches are actually uncompleted. You can see here, this person probably, while I was drawing him, he turned his head or he maybe walked away. So I wasn't able to complete this drawing. So there are a lot of uncompleted drawings here. And you can actually compile all the uncompleted drawings. Just keep drawing, just try and fill up the page. It doesn't matter if they are uncompleted, because the idea is to practice. The colors are most likely added at home because it's very difficult to use watercolor on the train. Even if you are using a water brush and a portable palette, it is still very challenging to add colors unless you are using markers. So this is a wide angle scene, something that I like to draw because it's very challenging, but it's also very fun. The important thing to note when drawing something like this is the proportion. So how do I usually start when drawing a scene like this? I would start with the person that is closest to me, which would be this person. In this case, I would draw the, make sure that the top and the bottom is in. As long as the top and bottom is in, all the other people, they will fit into the scene, because all these people, they are standing further away, they are going to be shorter compared to this person, so they will be in the scene. And when drawing all these people, make sure that you get their proportion right. Pay attention to where their feet intersects with this main person. For example, the feet of this lady here, it intersects this person at the pants there, and the head, it intersects here. So most of these people, their eye level is around this area. Some people will be a bit shorter. I am a bit tall, so I'm probably of this height, so the eye level, my eye level will be here. People who are shorter, their eye level would be a bit lower compared to me. So as I'm drawing, I just keep on comparing, make sure I know where their feet is going to end. Like this feet here, it ends here, but this feet here, it ends here. And people who are standing much further away, because of perspective, their feet is going to end even higher. And try to have overlaps. When you have overlaps, you can see the depth, like this person is in front of this, and this person is in front of this two person. So it gives a three-dimensional look and feel. Try not to be bothered with too much detail, because there is going to be a lot of detail. So I just draw the shapes. So this is a very simple sketch while I was at the train station waiting for my friend. So this is a very good way to pass time. And I drew the train station there. These are the gates. This is another sketch of a person that is standing, and I was standing also. I was standing across in front of him directly. Since he's playing with his phone, he did not notice that I was actually drawing him. Here's another sketch. Try to keep the shapes simple. Try not to add so much detail. Just draw the general shape will do. I mean, there may be wrinkles on the shirt, but those wrinkles, as long as they do not contribute to the shape of the person, the wrinkles, the lines that are within the shape, those are not that important. So I try just to draw the outline of the shirt, outline of the head, the hairline. Basically draw where I can see the most contrast. And here there are overlaps as well. So it's a very three-dimensional look. So all these sketches with a lot of people, I actually drew them while standing up. And it's very tiring to hold this sketchbook, because in order to draw something like this on this hardcover sketchbook, I actually have to hold it like this, so it can get a bit tiring. Let me show you the other sketchbook, a new sketchbook that I have started just a few days ago. This is a spiral bound sketchbook that I received from a fan of the channel. I wasn't able to remember the name, but this is made by Handbook. So they have three different quality, three different types of paper, 90 GSM, 190 GSM, 300 GSM. So this is the sketchbook with 190 GSM paper. This is spiral bound, so it's very convenient when drawing on the train. So this was drawn on the 3rd of February, that is 1 week ago. So I drew the lines with pen and ink, waterproof ink. I was using Noodler's bulletproof black ink and basically just finished the line art while I was standing on a train. So these people, they are all sitting down. This lady, she was very near to me. If I reach out my hand, I could touch her. So that's very close distance. And the thing to note here is the eye level again. So these two, they are standing, I am also standing, so their eye level is quite similar to me. And if you want to check before you draw, you can just pay attention to where all their eye levels are. So their eye level should be, generally speaking, in this area here. Different people have different heights, so their eye level may vary up and down. So after I finished the line art, I added watercolor at home. Try to write down the place where you draw, where you have drawn the sketch, and put down the date so that you can refer back to it years later. Now in this sketchbook, I did not write down the dates for some of the sketches, so I did not know when I drew them exactly. So I think it's good. It's a good habit to include the name of the place. For me, I include the train stations that I started drawing from to the train station where I stopped drawing. And these are just some random people on a train. So here I'm just practicing drawing people. I use a bit of contour line technique. Sometimes the shapes, they can be a bit challenging to draw, so I use contour technique. Just pay attention to the subject and not look at my sketchbook and just basically just draw and try to trace the outline that I see. Notice here that I use only three primary colors, red, blue, and yellow. Different shades of red. But the blue is just phthalo blue and yellow, and this is some orange. So just three primary colors. Here I use six colors, three primary and three secondary. The secondary colors are orange, purple, and green. So this is a bit more colorful compared to the earlier one. So when you have drawn your lines on the train, you can practice your color mixing, you can practice color theory at home. Just fill up a lot of pages like I do, and when I come back home, I will just try out different color theories, different color techniques to see which one looks the best. If you always draw people, if you have like 40 over pages of just people sketches, sometimes it can look a bit boring. The sketchbook may become monotonous, so I like to sneak in some sketches of actual places. This would give context to where you're drawing and make the sketches look a bit more give more variety to your sketches. So for the first few pages, I was just drawing the commuters, and if I keep drawing it like this, it's going to get a bit boring, so I try to mix it up a bit. This was also drawn at the train station. I added watercolor at home. It's a bit challenging to draw this because these are five escalators and people are moving up and down all the time. So while drawing this, I had to wait for people to alight from the train and then they would move up. I would try to keep a mental image and draw as quickly as possible. Try to remember where their eye level is and where their feet is going to end. So once you know the top and the end, you can sort of fit in the middle section. So this is the scene I was talking about. Before I drew this, I actually had to sit down and think about how
I'm going to do this because it is quite complicated. There are a lot of people. So after thinking for a while, I came up with a strategy, which is to draw the things that are not moving first. So I drew the escalator, I drew the walls on the side, and then I drew the people to fill up the scene. People who are waiting for the train, they are easy to draw because they are looking forward, and you can practice your proportion as well. Depending on how much time I have before the next train comes, I might draw a lot of people. If I have more time, I would add in more details. If I do not have a lot of time, I would just draw the general shapes of the people. This was recorded while I was standing up, so the eye level of all the people who are seated down, they are much lower than me. And usually I would not draw this scene because this is quite symmetrical. There are no people standing near me, so I'm not able to get the depth of view that I want. Usually when there are people close to me, the people who are closest will be very big, and people who are further away, they will be very small. And when you draw this contrast, it will look good in a sketchbook. But right now, as I'm looking at this scene, this is quite static to me. If you look towards the back of the train carriage, you will see that there are a lot of people, and that's the busier section. So before I get onto the train, I might actually just choose a busier train carriage to get on so that I have things to draw, and that would be a bit more interesting. The train is always shaking, so when you're drawing, the lines may tend to wobble a bit. I think that's alright. It makes your sketch look a bit looser. So now these people, they are alighting from the train. So the passengers from the next station, they are going to come on board, and I'm going to wait for them to settle down before I would start drawing, because if they are still moving around, they're fidgeting, it's very difficult to draw them. So I would just wait for them to just sit down.
And here I tried a different technique. I used pen, and instead of using watercolor, I tried to maybe try a different technique to cross hatch to see what kind of textures I can get out of the pen. So I like this texture here because the lines, they actually follow the contours of the t-shirt. But here you can see the mixed cross hatching is sort of destroyed the form. It looks quite flat to me. But here I can see the contour, and here I can see the contour as well. So it is all these contours that add that give you the suggestion of a form. And here I tried to use a different color scheme. It's a split complement, so I use red, and then I use colors that are opposite. The red would be green, and colors that are closest to green, yellow green and blue green. So it looks something like this. You can use different materials. You can use pens, black pens. Just now in the earlier sketchbook, I showed you that I use colored ink pens and markers sometimes, colored inks. You can use colored pencils as well, or you can use markers. So try out different things. It's a sketchbook. It's very fun to experiment with different materials and different techniques. So here I use analogous color scheme. So I use yellow, orange and red, basically colors that are close to each other on the color wheel. I think it's also good to include some sort of context. For example, don't just draw the people. Also draw the background so that you have some context. If not, these people may look like they are just floating in space. So here I have this handle here. But in this earlier sketch, it looks like they are floating in space. There is no background. And if you keep doing that, it may look a bit weird. So sometimes by adding the background, you give context to the sketch, it also grounds your characters. Another sketch using the same color scheme, also the analogous color scheme, yellow, red and orange. In this case, I added black to give it a bit more contrast, because in the earlier sketch, I was just using the bright colors. And these two sketches were drawn yesterday. I'm able to draw a lot of pages when I'm on a train, so the fastest way for me to fill up a sketchbook is actually to bring it outdoors and draw on public transport. I can fill up to maybe 4 pages for every train trip that I take. So here, this is the original line art. I have not added watercolor yet, but I'm going to do so later, perhaps. Oh, while I was drawing this, the person that is sitting next to this lady, she actually stood up and moved, so I wasn't able to complete this sketch. So I moved my eyes to another person who is sitting further away, and that's her. So one tip about drawing on a train is when the train door closes, wait for people to settle down before you start drawing them. And wait for people to stop moving, to stop fidgeting before you draw them. So wait for them to settle down. And as the train approaches the station, some people will stand up, and maybe that's the station where they are going to alight. So also pay attention to such things. Because if you know that they are going to alight, they start moving when the train station is approaching, you should probably stop drawing them, because there's not going to be enough time to complete that drawing. And for this sketch, I drew it in the vertical format because I want to get the whole character in as big as possible. So this lady was actually sitting down, but it looks like she is standing up. So this is very much like a coloring book style. And if you do not want to draw something so complicated, you can draw something very simple without a lot of details like this. So for this sketch, I just drew the general shapes of the jeans, the shoes, the t-shirt. Use very simple shapes for the hand, the head and the hair, and for this lady here as well. I think this is a good way to practice drawing silhouettes of people and drawing the general shapes. So I am definitely going to fill up one whole page with all these tiny drawings. So that's the fun thing about drawing on public transport and drawing so regularly. Every time you draw, sometimes a new idea would hit you. And in this case, I was just drawing these characters. I had a lot of time because my train station was quite far away. But when I'm starting to reach my destination, I only had like 5 minutes like that. So I know that I am not going to have enough time to complete a drawing like this. So I drew something very simple. I was forced to draw something very simple to complete it within the time before I have to step out of the train. People who are looking at their phones, who are reading, parents who are attending to their kids, those are the easy subjects because their attention is somewhere else. And if you want to practice, those would be the people that you should draw first, because they will not know that you're drawing them. It is actually the people who are not doing anything, people who don't have phones in their hands, those are the most challenging subject. For example, in this sketch here, this lady, I was drawing her yesterday, and she has nothing in her hand, so she was just looking around, checking the stops that are coming up. And it's very difficult for me to actually look at her, because if I were to look at her, I'll be like staring at her. So I use some of the techniques that I have taught you earlier, basically hold my sketchbook like this and just glance once in a while just to finish drawing her head, her face. And after I finish drawing her face, it's much easier there. I can just block the line of vision with my sketchbook and draw the rest of her body. So that's how I managed to draw this person. So just use a combination of techniques. And also, if it's really impossible to draw this person that you want to draw, just start drawing with draw another person that's beside her first, and then go back to the original person that you started with. So you can always jump around. You don't have to focus your attention on just that single person. If you are not able to draw that person, just move around to the next subject and to the next subject. So that's all for today's video. I hope it is helpful. You can challenge yourself to draw on public transport as well. I do this quite regularly, so for me it's no longer a challenge. I've been doing this for a few years and so far I haven't been caught once. I can actually sit down on the seat and there are people on the left and right side. I can be drawing like this. They might be playing with their phones or they might be checking out to see what I'm doing, but they usually don't bother me. So it's quite easy to practice here in Singapore. But in other countries, I'm not too sure how people would react. So try and draw something simple. Draw people who are distracted first. So thanks for watching. I hope this video is helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comment section below. And if you want more tips on drawing people, you can check out this book called Sketching People, an Urban Sketcher's Manual to Drawing Figures and Faces. This is by Lynne Chapman and this is a very good book. I will put out a proper video review for this book soon. Yeah, see you in the next video. Bye.